But there's a student response to it, so I cannot remove the activity. Let me hide that for a minute. So yes, you can do that. So if I come back to the journal tab, I can see my students and the different posts they've made. So let's say, just for fun, here's Abby. She made this in response to Reed, and I want to remove that activity from my classroom, but she's the only one. I have a couple of kids who might have responded to that. Like, oops, I want to change something to it. So you're going to click on the journal, click on their name, come down. We're going to scroll down a little bit, get out of the way. There we go. And the three little ice cream scoops that fell over, click on the three dots, and there is a way to delete item. So click on the journal, click on the student's name, find the activity you want to delete, the three ice cream scoops, click on delete item. It says, are you sure? Yes, let's delete it. And now that that's gone, you can go back to your activities and you can go through the same thing. Click on the three dots and delete the activity. This is the same thing you might want to do if a student doesn't do the assignment correctly. You're like, hey, that's not even close to what you're doing, or maybe they answered the wrong question. You can delete that activity, and that way it'll pop up for the student in the activities button, and they can redo that assignment for you.